Hey everyone, today we're going to be talking about UV islands, which is an important concept to understand in UV unwrapping. And some people don't actually know what people are referring to when they say UV islands. It's actually quite simple and there's only a couple of things we really need to cover. So let's just get into it. Here you can see I've UV unwrapped this object using just seams, and here is my result. So as you might understand, this whole thing here is the UV map. Something we won't get into today is that you can actually have more than one UV map, but this is a more complex topic that we'll cover in a later video in this series. Here you can see all these separate components which represent faces on this object here, which we have decided using these red lines or seams. If you don't understand what seams are, they're pretty much just like cuts on the object to turn it into these 2D shapes. However, I would recommend checking out the earlier videos in this series to get a better understanding of how seams are actually working. I'll leave the link in the description below to the playlist for all these UV unwrapping videos. And they will start from beginner to more of these more late beginner, early intermediate concepts. Each of these collection of one or more faces that are separated out are what we call UV islands. And the reason they need to be separated in the first place, as you know, is because we need to flatten out our object into a 2D plane. If I zoom in here, you can see there is a gap between my UV islands. And this gap is really important. What we want to avoid is having an overlap of our UV islands. The reason for this is if we are texture painting or texture baking, which is the process of turning any collection of nodes into an image texture, if there's overlap, it's going to create some issues because it's going to try and either paint or bake in the same place as another part of the model. What I'm going to do though is purposefully create a bit of an overlap to show you how this creates a problem. So first of all, how do we actually select a UV island? To do this, all we need to do is press the L key with our mouse hovering over an island. L stands for link, so we're essentially selecting everything linked to this island. Once you have it selected, you can then press G, and that would allow you to grab it and move it around. You can also use S to scale it or make it bigger or smaller, and R to rotate it. I'm going to press G and do something incorrect by overlapping these two islands here. You can also select your UV islands here in the 3D viewport where our object is. First of all, we will need to turn on this UV sync selection mode. This will mean if I press 3 on the keyboard to go into face select mode and select a face in here, you can see it selects it in the UV editor as well. If I turn that off, you can see only the selected face will be displayed, which is a little bit inconvenient most of the time. So I'm going to turn the arrows back on, and if I was to press L, you can see it's automatically selected everything contained within the seam, and it selected this here. But this won't always be the default. The default would end up just selecting everything, because all of this entire object is connected together. If that happens for you, just in this select linked box, which will open right after pressing L, open it up by pressing the arrow, and here you can see you've got a few options. If I shift left click the seam to turn it back to default, you can see it selected everything because this object is all connected together, and for the 3D viewport, that's just going to interpret the default of the linked select as just select everything connected. And here you've got a few different options, but the one we're looking for is seam. So I'll left click it again to turn it back on, and you can see it's now going to select everything linked. If I press L again, you can see I can now select this one here. So that's how we can select it in the 3D viewport as well. I'm going to quickly go into texture paint mode, and here I'm going to make sure I'm in my shader editor. You don't need to follow along with this because this isn't a texture painting tutorial. I just want to explain why the UV overlapping is bad. So I'm going to press the plus new, and here I'll press Shift A, and under texture, I'll choose image texture. I'll plug my color into the base color, and I'm going to press Shift A, then under input, I'll choose texture coordinate, and plug the UV into the vector. That just tells us that this image texture, which we're going to paint on, will use the UV map in order to calculate where it's painted. This is essential for texture painting. Then I'm going to press plus new to create a new image, and I'll just leave it at the default and press new image. Just to demonstrate, I'm going to change my editor type here from UV editor to image editor. This will allow us to texture paint in this menu as well. Then we just need to change it from view to paint. And I can select my draw brush here too. Then I can choose my image, which I'm using here, just to match this. And now when I start painting, I'm going to make my brush a bit bigger by pressing F and changing the size. I'll just paint across here. You can see that it's painted both the inside and the outside. And that's because this UV here representing the inside is overlapping with this one on the outside, which is going to make it pretty difficult if you're wanting to have different patterns in different areas. I'll just press texture paint, and I'm going to change it back to edit mode. And I'm going to go ahead and delete my texture. I'll then change it back to the UV editor. Hopefully that example gives you a better understanding of why we can't have these overlapping. So I'm just going to press L to select this island again and press G to move it so it isn't overlapping again. However, it's a little fiddly now because we have to position it, and although it seems to be okay that it's not overlapping, there's a way to automate this process. So as you can see, I've marked all the seams on this object. This should work just fine for a smart UV project as well, but if you have any concerns about your object or you're worried that you've missed a step, it never hurts to duplicate your object first as a backup. Then what I'm going to do is in edit mode I'll press A to select everything or all, and then U to open the unwrap menu and choose unwrap. You can see it's just going to unwrap it back to the default. In my unwrap menu here, you can see that there's a parameter called margin. This one's really important. If I was to set this to 0, while nothing is overlapping, everything is kind of joined together here and there's no separation. This can create issues similar to what I explained before, and that's why it's always better to have just a tiny gap in between. So what I would recommend is 0.01, and that gives a nice gap and should solve the issue for most texture sizes. But if you have any doubts, you can always do some research online to make sure the texture size you're using is using a pretty appropriate margin for Blender. Of course, experimenting yourself will also help you understand what's best. The bigger the gap, the less likely you are to encounter problems. However, the reason we wouldn't want to have a gap too big is so we can optimize the texture space, which although isn't as important in the VFX slash film industry, it is very important in the game industry, as we always want to optimize our texture space, as games work in real time and we don't have a million years to render a single frame. So every optimization counts in games. As you can notice, at the moment we are in Blender 4.2. And in 4.2, they've actually added a few additional UV features. I'm going to be covering this in the next video in the series, so make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell if you want to be notified when that video is released. Apart from that though, I hope that clears up a few confusions and understandings about what UV islands are in Blender and why they're important for UV unwrapping, texture baking, and texture painting. If you want to learn more, make sure to check out my UV unwrapping playlist, which will be having more videos added to it as we go, like the 4.2 new features for UV unwrapping, which I should be releasing tomorrow. Apart from that though, thank you so much for watching and take care.